Hi everyone, thanks for joining in. So in today's video, we will be drawing a beautiful door around the flower trees. Hope you will enjoy this painting. So the products which I'm using in this video is mentioned in the video description box. If you want to buy the product, please visit the links. As you can see that I've started my painting with a light sketch. So it is very important to draw the basic outline of your drawing before you proceed with your painting. So this will help a lot while applying the colors. So you can see that we have covered all the basic outlines which is required in our painting. So now we will apply some water. So the paper which I am using is a cold pressed paper which helps us to create a deep blurry effect in our painting. We have applied sufficient quantity of water. Now moving on to the colors. The first color which I am using is crimson in a very dilute form. So for the door, we will be using the same crimson color. So now I am applying a little bit of cobalt blue just to add some shadows in our painting. This will also help us to create a good cold effect in our painting. So for this tone, just add a little bit of yellow ochre mixed with crimson. So you can see that my colors are flowing here and there. So in this case, don't get panic. Allow the colors to flow because this is the first layer. We will not think much about like where the colors are flowing. So now adding a little bit of green to our painting just to make some leaves. So for this color, I'm using a sap green mixed with chrome yellow. So adding a little bit of cobalt blue to the ground. So we are done with our first layer. Now moving on to the second layer. So for the second layer, we will be starting by making the shadows of the flower tree. For this, I am using cobalt blue mixed with crimson. For the shadows of the flower tree, I'm using cobalt blue mixed with a bit of crimson. So for drawing the shadow on the door, we will be using the same crimson mixed with cobalt blue, but in this case, the cobalt blue would be more than the crimson. using the same crimson color mixed with a little bit of cobalt blue to draw the shadows. So working on the details now, just to refine the painting a bit. So to draw the flow, we will be using yellow ochre and a little bit of cobalt blue. So in this case, we will be adding both the warm tone as well as the cold tone to our floor. So now we will apply the second layer to our flower tree. For this we will mix crimson with cobalt blue. This layer will be a thick a bit than the previous one. So for the leaves, we will be using sap green mixed with cobalt blue, and in some cases for more darker tone, we will be adding a little bit of Persian blue with the sap green. So now I'm adding a little bit of Bunshina mixed with sap green. So now I'm working on the details by adding a little bit of more crimson to the door just to make it pop out. To draw the flower pot, I'm using Bunshina, so you can also add a little bit of crimson if you want to add the shadows at the same time. So to add the further details in our painting, we will be using the same crimson mixed with cobalt blue and sap green mixed with cobalt blue. So for drawing these lines on the door, I'm using crimson mixed with cobalt blue. So to add the further details, we will be using the same crimson color mixed with the cobalt blue. So to add the further details, we will be using the same crimson color mixed with the cobalt blue. So now I'm just adding a little bit of details in our painting just to refine our painting. As you can see, like, I'm drawing some small leaves. So you can see, like, we have completed our painting. Now removing the masking tape. I hope that you have enjoyed the painting. If you did, don't forget to like the painting and share with your friends. And subscribe this channel for more upcoming watercolor paintings. Thank you so much.